We have no less than 17 super effects in Create Studio Pro by the time I'm recording this video and counting. The dev team is constantly adding new effects each month. So, 17 effects, but did you try each and every one of them? This is Victor with a new Create Studio Pro tutorial. Today I am going to tell you about the inner shadow effect, and I will demonstrate some examples to show where could this effect be very useful. I decided to make this tutorial as some of you have requested in my YouTube channel's comments. So, let's bring in a rectangle that will serve me as a background. I'll go here to the color selector and I will change its color and make it orange. Next, I will add a text, and the font that I'm using for this example is MOLOT. This font I imported myself. MOLOT is a heavy sans serif typeface. It is only available in one weight and only have uppercases. We don't even have any italics, but it is a high impact font, as you can see. This is a free commercial font, and I'll leave a link in the description below to check it out. To import your own fonts, you simply go here. We have here our fonts library. We also have Google Fonts integration. We have our favorites under this little heart here, and by clicking on the plus sign, we can import our own fonts. You can choose to load a folder with an entire font family or simply load a single font file. You choose it from your local drive, give it a title, and here it is. You can hit import. I will delete this one now because I already have it in my fonts library. Okay, type in some text, and I want this to be bigger, so I scale it up and change the letter spacing to 100. I am changing its color to the same orange color as my background. Now I go to the effects on the left side to just grab this inner shadow effect and just drop it here on the text. You can see that it has been applied on my text, and if I go and click here on the effect, this little menu pops up and I can change the color of the shadow, I can change direction of the shadow, I can also change the distance and the blur of the shadow. You can play with it to find the perfect setting for your project. I set mine like this, and let's animate this text a little bit. I go to motion presets, and for the in animation I'll choose fade, and I select fade in. I want this to animate my text by letter, and I'll choose expo easing. And now if I play this animation, let's see how it looks. Maybe it will look better if I extend the time duration of the motion preset animation a little bit. So let's see how it looks now. I will want to show you another example of a totally different use of the inner shadow effect. I will bring in a rectangle for my background, and for this one I will choose a linear gradient color. I go here to the popular gradients and I'll choose this blue gradient, and you can see that I have here these two nodes on the color swatch. To change the color of these nodes, you simply click on the one you want its color changed, and you can tell which one is active by the little triangle over that node. Now I want to change the direction of this gradient, so to do that I'll just grab this left sign handle and move it here on the bottom edge of the background, and this one on the right I will move it up here on the top. Next, I will bring in a circle. I will change the color to this light blue, and I want this to be a radial gradient, so I switch to radial gradients. To better understand the difference between a linear gradient and a radial gradient, I will quickly demonstrate how are these two different. So I have here these two squares. On the left I have a linear gradient, and you can see that by moving this node I can change the direction of this gradient. Please notice that the component colors of this gradient are distributed on linear channels. On the right, I have a radial gradient, and you can see that if I grab this node and I'll bring it here in the center, the component colors of the gradient are distributed on circular channels. So, back to our inner shadow example. I will click on this color node on the right and just make it darker a little bit. I am changing the direction of the gradient, and I think like this would be just nice. I will bring in another circle, select this light blue color for this one as well, and for the gradient node on the left, I will set a white color. For the node on the right, I will bring the opacity all the way down. I go on and reposition the direction of the radial gradient like this, and I want this one to be bigger a little bit. And if I drag it on a side, you can see that this circle is like a white glow. This was my intention. Let's place it back here where it was, and now I need another circle to mask the white glow that I just created. I will rename this one as mask, and selecting both circles, I will mask the white glow with the blue circle. Now I can go on and bring the inner shadow effect and just drop it on the circle right here above the background. I go here on the top right corner, and by opening these settings I will change the angle of the inner shadow, and I will also change the color of the shadow, and I'll choose this dark gray color right here. You can adjust the color by your own preferences to have it just the way you like it. Now that I have it as I want, I could have just simply chosen to only add a radial gradient for my circle to create this sphere 3D effect. But in my experience, I found out this combination of radial gradients and inner shadow to get me a smoother sphere 3D effect. I can go on and select these two elements and group them together so I will be able to scale the whole group. It is totally up to you if you want to go the simple way or to work a little bit more for a better result of your visuals. This is a short and quick example on how to use the inner shadow effect. You can explore this effect and all the other effects that we have in createstudio pro by practicing and trying multiple and different designs, and you'd be amazed of the power of all these effects. If you'd like to see more tutorials, be sure to also check other videos on my channel. I am sure you will find something interesting. After all, we all have something to learn from one another. Don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and hit that notification bell to be notified for the upcoming tutorials on my channel. Have a great day and have fun creating!